I'm just a normal person with no video editing background who wanted to start making YouTube videos and maybe cool transitions and effects. I don't really plan on being a professional video editor, so I was looking for a free, easy to learn video editing software. Luckily, I stumbled on Shotcut, a free open source video editing program that can do many of the tricks you can do on more enterprise video editors like Adobe Premiere or DaVinci Resolve, but with a much simpler and leaner interface, thus dramatically shortening the learning curve. It just takes using your imagination. So let's learn together. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to use the gradient filter. And this was a request from someone at the Shotcut forum. So I wanted to play around with it. I'm not too familiar with the gradient filter as well. So I wanted to play around with it and see what the best use case is for that gradient filter. In order to do that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to change this gray sky into a blue sky. And from all the testing that I've done, I think that's the best use case. Typically, it would be best for a sky replacement or some sort of way to switch one color to another. So that's going to be the project that we're going to be doing in this tutorial. I'm going to show you two different methods. First, I'm going to show you what I believe is the standard method. The second method is kind of a hack that I've played around with and how I like to execute things. And the reason why I have a second method is because I believe the second method makes it a lot easier to control how the color blends and how it's positioned within the video. And so first and foremost, I'm going to show you the simple method. Before I get started, I want to make sure that you are using the same version as I am, and that is Shotcut version 20.07.11. And so that we're both using the same version and we can make sure that the same functionalities apply. So as I said, in this tutorial, I'm going to try to replace the gray sky of this image or this video that I downloaded online. And so first and foremost, let's go ahead and drag the file into the timeline. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to isolate say a 5 second section of this so that we can see a change between a gray sky and a blue sky. So I'm gonna cut a 5 second snippet, and this area here is what we're going to be focusing on. And so now that that's been cut, let's launch the filter interface. And we're going to search for gradient, like so. And right when you choose it, all of a sudden, that area is going to be grayed out, or you're going to see a gradation. So, you know, when I click out of it, you see the video, and you see the video on the other side. But when I click into the area where the filter is applied, all of a sudden, the video disappears. But don't worry about that. So first and foremost, what we're gonna do is I want this sky area here to be blue. And so let me toggle back. So this area here that is currently assigned white in this section right here, I wanna turn that to, let's say, this color blue, right there. And then this area here that is assigned black right here, I'm gonna make that white by clicking. All I'm doing is I'm clicking it and it launches this new color palette section. So I'm gonna choose white. So now we have that. How do you then apply it to the video? Well, when you first launch the filter, it defaults to the blend mode overlay or over. All you have to do is move it down to multiply, and all of a sudden it becomes transparent and you can see the blue overlaid on top of the original video. But what has happened here is the blue has bled all the way down to the bottom of where this river is. And I don't necessarily need that area to be blue. So all I need to do is, so there's actually little handles here at the end of this. And so I'm just gonna click and I'm just gonna drag it. And as you click and drag, you're gonna notice the blend changes. And so I'm gonna say I want it to start the blend from right there. I'm gonna show you what it did by deactivating multiply and putting it back to overlay. And basically what I told it is that I want it to blend from white to blue starting from right here at the end of this handle. So I'm now going to move it back to multiply again. And so this is what it looks like without the filter. And you're going to notice that as it transitions to this part here, which is red, it's going to start turning the sky blue, and then as it exits that red area, it's going to go back to the gray sky again. So let's play it. Actually, you know what? I'm going to deselect that area. I'm going to select it here so that that little handle is not showing up. So let's play it again. So that's basically the best use case, I believe, for the gradient filter. Now, if this sky here looks a little too saturated and look a little too artificial, all you have to do is go back into this color picker. You can either choose one of the basic colors here in the existing color palette, or you can just click and drag this section here until you find kind of the perfect sky blue. Maybe that's good right there. If I click it, all of a sudden, look at that. So now it's a little bit more natural blue. Wait, unclick. I don't want that little handle showing up. Okay, so let's... So I think that's a little bit more natural. And so really that's it. That's how I would use the gradient filter. Now, as I mentioned, I have a second method, which I believe is actually a better method. Because right now, really the only way you can control the color is to go over here to this color area here, click it, and then choose the color that you want, overlays it, and then you get the exact blue of whatever the hell you picked over here. But the way I would do it is kind of similar to how Adobe Premiere uses an adjustment layer. I don't want to apply the filter right on the video itself. What I want to do is I want to create a track here by right-clicking the V1 track. I want to insert another track. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply all the filters on this separate track so that I can leave this clip alone. I don't want to make any modifications to the clip itself. And so I'm going to go to the second track here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the section called Open Other right there. When you click it, I'm going to choose Color. And in this one, I'm going to choose the color white and click OK. And then while this white is on your preview screen, all I'm going to do is drag it right into that track that I just created. So now we have a white. Actually, you know what? I'm going to move it over here so that I can isolate this other section here, between here and here. And so in this area here, let's move it a little bit more so that there's a difference. So in this area here, what I'm going to do is now I'm going to click filter and I'm going to load a gradient. And now I just applied the gradient to this top area right there. Here, let's make it a little bigger. So that white section right there. Again, the only reason why we're seeing this black and white gradient is because it's defaulted to over instead of multiply. But before I do anything, what I'm going to do is, once again, I'm going to select this, what represents this handle right here, which is actually this thing here. So I'm going to click that. I want that to be white. And then the representative of this handle right here, which is this area here, I believe. Nope, did I just mess that up? Actually, this area right now is actually this thing right here. So I'm going to click that. I'm going to make that white. Okay, so that changed. Now this area right here is represented by this area here. So I'm going to click that. And I want that to be blue. Like, let's pick like a super, super dark blue, like that. And now, the same as what we did in the original version, I'm just going to select multiply. So that didn't really do anything. Now, why did it not do anything? Because it applied the multiply really to this layer. But it's still covering up this layer right here. So actually what I want to do is I want to go here. This section here. I want to choose properties. And I want to set the blend mode for the entire track to multiply. So now it's doing exactly what it did in this section here. But we're going to add an additional step. So first, again, I'm going to do what I did before. I'm going to grab this little handle here and move it a little bit up just to make the blend a little bit more realistic. And so again, we ended up with what the other one looked like, which is it's a blend from white to really, really dark blue. Now, why go through this extra step when I did the exact same thing in this other layer? This is why. Now that I actually have this as a separate layer, I can, while it's selected, I can go to filter. I can go into opacity, right? And right now it has 100% opacity, which means the color, it's at 100% color or 100%. So it's opaque, 100% opacity. So the more I drag it to the left, the more transparent it becomes. And look what happens. So as I drag it, I can control the color. Aside from that, I can still go over to gradient and I can choose a more natural color, like I did before. Let's say, like sky blue, like that. So it's still a more natural color, but on top of that, it added this additional control in the opacity right here. I can drag it and I can then change it. I can go, okay, you know, I want the sky to be a little lighter, I want the sky to be a little darker, whatever. And so this is why I would apply the gradient filter to replace the sky on a separate track, just so I can control that. And then say I hide that track, no modification. If you look at the filter here on this, in the filter section, I did not modify the original image. And so later on I can come back if I need to do any kind of color grading or any kind of changes to sharpness or contrast, I could still go back to this original video and apply that. And so that's my technique. Again, use it, don't use it. I've shown you two different versions of how to apply the gradient filter. If this has been useful to you, I definitely would appreciate a subscribe. Like this video, comment on this video. If you have any other suggestions on how you would utilize the gradient filter, I'd love to hear from you as well. If you have any other suggestions on what other tutorials you'd like me to do, I'd love to hear that as well, because this one right here, this particular tutorial, was actually a suggestion from someone in the Shotcut forum. So once again, thank you guys for visiting. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you later. Bye-bye.